Hello guys, so in this lecture we will be doing pricing rules optimization. So I'll be creating a pricing rule structure for this and then apply a pricing for that. So I would create a structure live in front of you, and then I would also do that in the GAM account for you. So yeah, let's get started. Firstly, we would be using this Excel sheet to actually determine the structure. Now in the structure, I have listed four levels. Level one is your device category. So this is something that, you know, you can apply on your own. So this is something that will be existing for all the publishers. So at level one, we want to segregate between desktop and mobile because we are assured that its CPM varies a lot. So desktop CPMs are usually higher than of mobile. Then operating systems. We are also aware that, you know, let me write that down first. Okay, we are also aware that iOS has lesser CPMs than compared to Android, and this is generally the same for all the publishers. At level two, we would be distinguishing between the operating system and creating different pricing for iOS and Android. Now for the country, let's go into the GAM and pull a report of country. So our goal is to find the top countries and then create separate pricing for them. So let's actually find in the top countries, and we will come to know that, and this would help us actually, you know, finding the relevant pricing. So we can either do that in terms of revenue or just wait. Let's take in a certain longer duration. Okay, so right now we can think in terms of USA, Canada, UK, Australia. So I am listing down these five countries: USA, Canada, United Kingdom, Australia, Pakistan, India. Okay. And then lastly, it would be rest of the world. Okay. So in our case study, we would be avoiding overlaps, and this pricing strategy will not have any overlaps. So, okay, we have the countries in here, and I've listed them down because the country list is a little bit huge. And also let's find in the top two ad units. In terms of revenue, let's just take, okay, let's do this for the latest, like around 9th. And let's just filter here by, you know, average eCPM. So interstitial top header, ad unit, interstitial. This is the, you know, unit we created, and you can see that it has got the highest ad eCPMs. Then we have the top header. Okay, so rest of the world, rest of ad units. Now, so let's start creating a pricing rule structure. I am actually copying this and moving this below so that if we need to add and remove rows, it's much easier for us. So let's list down the ad unit in the last row. Or like, let's do it, remaining ad units, RA. RA would be an acronym that would be identifying remaining ad units. So we are creating separate pricing for interstitial top header, and we are clubbing remaining ad units. Now let's pick up countries. Now at countries, we have to actually pick up all the countries and repeat this step for all the countries: USA, Canada, United Kingdom, Pakistan, India, rest of the world. So this list would be a little bit huge, so I'm just dragging and dropping it here. Okay, sorry, this was rest of the world. Now let's just copy these across in here. One more row. Okay, one more row again, one more row again. Okay, one more row again. Okay, now operating systems. So we would have to create this, but for desktop we do not want to focus on any operating systems, so we can simply list desktop in here. Desktop, for that desktop operating systems are null, so this all will remain same for desktop. Now let's copy this for mobile. Okay, desktop, mobile, and in terms of mobile we'll have separate operating system. So iOS, and let's copy this again, Android. So guys, if you must have noticed, we are not creating any overlaps in the pricing, so we are keeping certain segments and then adding on other segments. So the goal of this is, if we add in top performing segments, like if we club in desktop for United States and the interstitial adherent, we are combining three categories, for this pricing rule the pricing would be the highest. So if you follow this pricing, it will be rest assured that your pricing is falling into the right bucket. Now let's simply give this pricing a name, A and B and C. Okay, let me now actually fill in the rest. So desktop, let's drag and drop it until in here. Similarly mobile, let's drag it all the way. Okay, similarly for operating system, here it can stay blank, but for iOS we can actually bring it up until here. For Android it can come until here. So this is how our pricing is looking like. Simply drag. Or let's wait, we can still copy this again. So from US to ROW, US till ROW. Okay, yeah, so this is it. We have finished our pricing rule. So last, this is an pricing rule that is targeting Android ROW, and ROW it is targeting rest of the adherents. So this is the pricing rule structure that we have created, guys, and I'm actually going ahead and giving it names. Okay, so these are 54 pricing rules. These are 54 pricing rules that we have created, and I know it is a lot of work at the start, but if you get it right, it will ensure that your pricing is set optimally. So this is our pricing rule name. And pricing, you needn't worry about pricing right now, as we have certain pricing rules that aren't overlapping. We can simply go ahead and choose optimized pricing. So if you apply this pricing, it is rest assured that you would not need to touch your pricing rules again and again. This is for once setup, and this would work optimally for you 95% of the time. So the optimized pricing doesn't work well when you are applying it on a broader level pricing. It works great if you have a pricing rule structure that is granular enough and without any overlaps. So this is my pricing rule structure that I would recommend to you. I am also sharing it, sharing this Excel sheet with you so that you can use it as a reference. Now we would go into the GAM UI and I would guide you how to apply, these for certain pricing rules, 1 to 2 pricing rules, and then you would be all good to do this on your own. So we are back into the GAM UI. Let's go into inventory and then pricing rules. So let's go into inventory and pricing rules. Now we would start creating our new pricing rules, starting with the first one. Okay, now its name suggests that it should be targeting desktop, United States, interstitial. Now firstly is desktop, so in device category we select desktop. I'm also clubbing in connected TV, and for mobile I'll be clubbing these. So first part of the targeting is done. Then in the geographies we are selecting United States, so second part of the targeting is also done. Then in ad units we are mentioning in here interstitial. Okay, so this is it, guys. Now one thing that would be remaining is the pricing, and the pricing we are choosing for all the ad units or all the pricing rules is optimized pricing. So let's go ahead and click on save. Now I would go ahead and apply this pricing. Now that is the similar steps you have to apply for the remaining pricing rules. Now let me show you a unique case wherein how you will tackle like rest of the ad units. In here we'll apply an exclusion. So let me do this targeting for you, and once that is done it should be all easy. So device category in here is desktop, so in here you can select desktop. Then in country select United States. Okay, countries we are selecting in United States, and rest of the ad units. So in rest of the ad units we just take in the top 2 ad units and exclude the rest. So we are just excluding these 2 ad units. So this means this pricing rule will be targeting all the ad units except these 2. So rest of the ad units you will apply this by doing this. Now interstitial, desktop, United States, and rest of the ad units. So it is done. Interstitial and top header, United States and desktop. So and on the pricing you are going ahead and saving it. Now guys, we would repeat the steps for all the pricing rules. Please go ahead and set all these 51 pricing rules. This is for one setup, but it will ensure that your pricing rules are correctly optimized and your revenue stays on top. We would come in here to see the impact of all the changes we made and analyze the revenue impact. But for now, this series ends in here. I hope it had been a learning experience for you, and I would recommend you to actually like and subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for more such case studies wherein I would be doing this for a lot of publishers.